But, I mean, a lot of the people that are in this group now, some of them we were friends with prior. Others, we got to know because they were interested in, like, hey, I want to join this. And I was like, okay, well, like, I want to get to know you. I want to be your friend, you know. Because, like, that's an important thing in a cosplay group, that you, you know, you should want to be friends with the other members. Because if there's tension there, or you're kind of like strangers, then, you know, it's kind of hard to, how would you, like, really interact and hang out and have fun. Which is why we do our cosplay meetup for International Cosplay Day. We did it last year on the last Saturday of August, and we're doing it again this year on the last Saturday. And it's not just for our group, it's for anyone in Asheville that wants to do it. Because, you know, we want to meet up with the community. And it gives a lot of cosplayers a chance to try out, you know, maybe one of their big driving con cosplays that they've been working on. Because I know that's the next week after that. So I'm like, you know, you can come get some photos of that new cosplay out in, you know, good lighting. We invite photographers. Last year we really didn't have any come, we just had her, she does all of our group photos. Which a lot of people still ended up being pretty happy with their photos.
And we had Debiella show up and talk to her about the league. Yeah, you forgot your sister. You forgot Evie does photography too. Yeah, she took photos last year. Y'all went to see the kids on the park too. Yeah, I didn't go.
Okay, I'm sorry.
And, you know, just throw me under the bus. But, to further explain what she's saying about becoming friends with group members, we had, I met my friend Eric at a comic con, and I decided to be friends with them, sort of join the group, and then from there, I've got my best friend now. So it surprised you who you will meet and what would happen. I didn't before Eric. She was my solo best friend, but she's also my sister, so there comes a time you need your own best friend that isn't your sister.
Twin sister, actually, too.
Yeah.
You're a Mel Jacket's
fan. I know it,
Paul. Okay.
I don't want to reach down.
It's just a mom thing, sorry.
Any other questions?
Oh, so I just something about what you said about supporting the local content cons. But so that if I've gone to a lot of the local cons, including even some of the ones down in Greenville, like the SC Comic Con, that is still somewhat considered local because it's in the same TV media market as Asheville. Then so from there's, but. If you like attention, which I think some of these most people who cosplay, obviously, by like just by going to these local cons of one, is that sometimes when I'm on public, someone will just randomly stop me and ask if I was at such and such con. So at times people actually recognize me from like being at cons. then my talk with them about anime or shows for a bit before I go on my way sometimes. When I'm out in public, people just recognize me, or in some cases, because I get times I like to walk it, that you're, that's actually last year I was crazy enough to actually walk the 1.6, it's more like 1.6 miles from where I live to and back from AARC, because I'm a bit of a crazy a beast, but it's like I actually did that, but it's so, been at times of walking others, I've actually had to have people that as they drive by actually yell out to me. I believe it's not always people that I recognize, but I think it's because they recognize me from cons around here that I just gather attention. People recognize me. But locally, just because by going to local cons, obviously a lot of the people, especially in small ones like this, will be people that live here. So in some ways, if you love attention, in some ways it's better to actually go to local cons because it'll be recognized outside of cons by the same people.
Yeah. And I've been to, I've had several people that have been like, haven't I seen you before? Like, even if they've only ever seen you once. and it was in a different cosplay, and they'll be like, haven't I seen you before? I'm like, I don't know, have you? List your cons. I'm sure I've been to one of them. I've had somebody that's like, haven't I seen you before? And I think it was last week. That was after. And I was like, I don't know, have you? And they were like, I've only ever been to one of the cons. I was like, so which one was it? And they were like, con. I was like, okay, see, I was there. I wasn't a Viking. I was Mal. So, and I was like, but yes, if you remember me, then yes, I was there. I had
something like that happen. I was going at two different cons. The first one was Hickory, and the second one was Lincolnton. Well, I saw someone at Lincolnton, and I was not Lincolnton, but Hickory, and I was talking with him for a bit. And then I went my very way. At Lincolnton, he comes by the table, and he's like, you're the film girl from Hickory. I told him. Like, Jackie, do you remember that there was like a film right here? At least I thought. Okay,
and we have various members like all over the United States. We have one in what?
Philadelphia,
New York, Florida.
A majority of our members
South
are
Carolina.
Based here in Western North Carolina.
California? Well, she's your friend. She was with the 501st, but she's still.
But most of them are from here. I want this to end up being something where, you know, different people in different states want to come together and do the same thing and want to include adults and teens in various hospitals and stuff, because I just feel like there should be a good purpose behind it sometimes, if that makes sense.
Well, like, there is a Superman downstairs. He's our Superman from League Extraordinary Appalachian. He's part of our group. He was in the panel last year. Kathleen, who just walked out because she has to go to work today, she's not dressed in a costume. Of course, Leonard.
Yeah, was eventually getting that first suit, and I will be so happy when that happens. Because at the same time, We call it a cosplay group, but we have first years too, because, you know, there's some cosplay stuff that first years can do too, because I've seen it. And, you know, they have their own community, but sometimes their community can be a little harsh as well. And, you know, kids have first years too, but they really don't care what a first year looks like. They just think, oh my god, it's this big, fluffy animal thing. And, like, especially with the bright colors. I commend anyone who gets a fursuit or makes one, because those are tedious looking to make, and they are expensive as all heck to purchase.
Summer, they're very hot unless you have the
yes,
coolers
very,
in it.
Yes, they're very, very hot. I think I burned up in some of my cosplays. I can't imagine wearing an entire fursuit. We want to include all of that. You know, we try to do panels and stuff anywhere we can do a panel. Like here, registration opened up in January. I was like, I want to do a panel. I'm like, how about registration for the panel? Because I know once they fill up, they're done. And, you know, I try to do panels anywhere we can get a panel. And we've done it on specific subjects and then non-specific subjects. Like today, it's more about our group and our families and our cosplay, as opposed to last year when we did the whole BC. Because, you know, I like doing it. I like an opportunity to talk to others about cosplay or the group or, you know, like beginner cosplay or whatever. The last panel we did was at the Hickory Con, and it was on beginner cosplay. And, you know, we had a lot of questions, but I was answering them a bit differently than you would see most people, because, again, I was answering from a beginner perspective. And a bunch of new perspectives. But, like, I like to do panels. And whenever there's, like, other group members in our group, I'm like, hey, you want to come do a panel? if you want to do this panel, we'll do this panel. Because I do want to do a panel, but I want to do a panel with someone. I don't want to do the panel by myself. I mean, I'm normally not by myself, she's here too, but I'm like, if we needed somebody else to want to do the panel too, that'd be great.
Not that you need me though, I mean, you talk 90% of the time.
Because you don't really talk during him at all.
I'm waiting for an opening.
You have no clue.
Do we have any more questions?
Well, another thing, y'all have we've encouraged your dad. He went to his first con last week. My husband, who will be Green Arrow when we get his costume. He hates green, but that's my favorite.
Fellow cosplayers as well as non-cosplayers, like, hey, you should come do this cosplay, or you should cosplay in general. Like, please, 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 please. I mean, you'd be surprised if you're nice enough to certain people. They may actually cosplay. Because there are some people that don't do it because they might be told by someone that they can't or something. And then you're there to say, hey, you can. Don't listen to them. They're not important here. Because, you know, you want to be a good person. You want to be a nice person. Whenever other cosplayers see you, you want them to think, oh, there's that really nice cosplayer. Not, oh, there's that stuck up cosplayer. Which I, for some odd reason, feel like some cosplayers look at me that way, and I don't exactly know why, because I'm like, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just doing it. I make a cosplay, when I show up to a con, I talk to other cosplayers, I freak out over other cosplayers. Like, if I were to run into cosplayer up there or at any time, I'd probably freak out, you know, be like, I love your cosplay. And like, that's another thing, when you're complimenting someone's cosplay, you need to take the time to think about what you're saying. Because some things may seem nice to you, but they may be a little, like, I've had some people that have been kind of like, I thought it was something you bought at the Halloween store. And I mean, sometimes I take that as a compliment because sometimes the Halloween store does good. But then sometimes I also kind of take it as an insult because sometimes the stuff at the Halloween store is kind of cheap. So I'm like, is it good or is it cheap? I don't know. Maybe, you know, you want to carefully
keyword.
You don't want to make them feel like they're any less than someone else. Like when you're looking at a cosplayer, you definitely don't want to compare when you're cosplaying. You don't want to compare them to, oh, you're almost as good as this other cosplayer that cosplays this character. Because then they're going to think my cosplay is not good enough. Because I'm almost as good as, but I'm not as good as. Like, if that makes sense, then, you know, you get it. You know, you want to, as much as it seems like it's harder to do it that way, you want to carefully consider how you compliment the cosplayer. Because a compliment can either make or break a person, especially a cosplay. Because you never know what they're going through anyway. They might be going through a hard time, they might be going through a lot of bullying or something. And you know, you kind of want to be that something that makes their day brighter rather than pulls them down. Like, there's a lot of negativity in cosplay and outside of it, so I kind of want to, in this group, in myself personally, and, you know, encouraging you all to kind of be, like, a more enlightening side of cosplay, to be nice and be considerate. And if a cosplayer needs help, see if you can help them out. I mean, I've held stall doors for cosplayers in the bathroom before. I don't mind it. You know, they may have this huge cosplay on. I really don't mind it as long as, you know, I'm helping. Just try to take a moment to consider if there's something you might be able to do for another cosplayer that might encourage them to kind of like pay it forward. Because I feel cosplay room, the community might be a bit better than what it is.
Remember how y'all really started? It all started pretty much being a character, choosing characters that would be together for their birthday party. And from there, it just spun out into bigger things. Every year, this was their birthday. This year. Next year, it's going to be Star Wars graduation / birthday party. So that's going to be huge. Getting your dad into Anakin. It's going to be interesting.
That's one thing about it. You know, there are going to be different things that bring a person into cosplay. It's not always going to be the same. And nobody's cosplay story is any different than anybody else's. No less. Or if not more. And, you know. Another thing I want to point out is because I've been on the receiving end of this quite quickly, I'm kind of running out of time and it kind of is off the subject a little bit. But if you're going to have props for a cosplay, make sure you have a handler or that you can for sure handle it. Because I have been on the receiving end of being hit with humorous people's props before. I definitely know it wasn't on purpose. But you need to consider when you need a prop. Am I going to be able to handle this? Do I have a handler that can help me with it? Or do I have a friend that can help me with it if I have to go to the bathroom? Like, I'm going to have Ahsoka carries two lightsabers. One's like 32 inches and the other's 36. So like, whenever I go to a con, I'm going to depend on my sister or my mom to hold my lightsaber if I need someone to hold it. But other than that, I will be taking them under the knowledge that I can handle them whenever I have them.
Yes, she owes you for Cinderella.
If you do happen to accidentally have an accident with someone in your prop, try to be nice about it, because I know sometimes some people, I've unfortunately hit someone with one of my props before. It was definitely an accident. It was a long bow. And they were a little rude about it. I mean, I apologized and I was like, I'm very sorry. And they were just kind of like, well, you need to watch what you're doing with your prop. And I'm like, well, everybody's like shoulder to shoulder in here. I'm trying my hardest. It was a complete accident. But I mean, at the same time, you know, it was at a point during the con where it was getting kind of late. I had already like been around. So at the same time, I probably could have handled my prop. But like, even if they're rude, try to be nice about apologizing.
And then, of course, your sister knows the receiving end of people being rude because of her Cinderella being real poofy. It shouldn't be that big. And it's like,
that
whoa.
That dress is too big. Yeah. I'm like,
have you seen some of the other stuff that people's worn before? Like, yeah, how's it too big?
And there's like this girl and she had like 5 foot long wings. I'm like, you think her dress is too big?
Yeah, at South Carolina Comic Con, I was trying to hold up on my dress, but it's a bit of a challenge when you're wearing a giant pink skirt and a long train in the back. And for the most part, I had it. But then I put it downstairs to look at something at a table. Well, I went to go pick it up, and I was literally moving it so hard that literally someone could have noticed it. There was a guy standing on my trail, and I kept moving it, and I kept saying hello, and he kept, and I was like, oh, well, I'm sorry, you shouldn't be wearing that. This is too big.
You'll get some of those though.
I think that just about wraps it up because we're out of time. I would encourage you all to pick up one of these cards about our group because I forgot my mini flyers. Because I would like everybody to know or, you know, have the links so that they know about our meetup in August, because I do want a lot of crossroads to come. I want to see this stuff be fun. And it's only for like 11 to 3. So I definitely would encourage you guys to come to that and get some photos.
Thank them for coming too.
Dude, I had to one of the stories that I've heard from a different company about the bit of a disaster with a prop and not being able to handle it. One time I heard the story of this one kind of this person that was in the dealer's room, but had this really long prop, and somebody called to them.